Medusa is a bidirectional UI framework that works together with Hydra to allow for micro-frontends. Think front-end as microservices. You can develop parts of your functionality as independent applications and have them work as one. Most of the logic for working together like that is encompassed in the Hydra project, our gateway proxy, which can do things like service discovery, combined security, canary deployments, and stuff like that. So be sure to check out that project if you're interested. Medusa itself is the UI framework for the independent applications themselves. We call it bidirectional because it uses WebSockets by default. That means that, unlike an average client-server application, data can flow from both the client to the server and from the server to the client. So for example, if Hydra detects a service went down, it can make parts of the website unavailable in a graceful way. Or if you have a notification alert, you don't need to do pulling constantly. You just get an update when the server alerts you, hey, there's a new notification. A final goal of Medusa is to limit the friction between UI and Java backend implementations drastically. Let's showcase this with a little example, which will also serve as an introduction to Medusa. So we start a new Maven project from start.spring.io, and we make sure to select Webflux. We extract it and open it up. And we make sure to add the Medusa library. This will make the Medusa functionality available to us. Under Source Main Resources, we can now add our page. And we write pages just in HTML, like you're used to. I'm going to call it button-sample.html. I'm not going to make it too difficult. I'm going to start with a counter and a button. If I click on the button, I want the counter field to increase by one. Simple, right? So I make the HTML with a button and a paragraph where the field is going to be shown. And I'm not going to add interactivity yet. First, I want my page to render just at all. So with the HTML made, now I create the event handler. If you're used to working with Spring, great. This is basically your controller class, but just for WebSockets. I'm going to call it my first event handler, and I'm going to annotate it with @UIEventPage. In this annotation, I basically make the link between the backend implementation and the pages and the URL that I'm going to provision it on. I say this page is available on /myfirstexample. This is the URL that it'll be available on. And I point it to the HTML page that I made, which was button-sample.html. All right, let's run this for the first time. And you can see I can load up the page, go to /myfirstexample, and I see the HTML being loaded. Great. Now let's add the interactivity. First, I'm going to implement my frontend. I can do this with Medusa tags, which are basically just prefixed HTML tags that give you extra functionality. I can put in the XSD for this if I want some autocomplete help, though this part is completely optional. And in this case, I'm going to add an m:text tag to render some text, the counter. As item for the tag, I'm going to put the name of a variable that will contain this value. I'm just going to call it my-counter. And I'm also going to add an m:click attribute to the button. This specifies the event that I'll be calling. So let's call our action increase, and let's put 1 as a parameter here, just to show you that parameters are a thing and literals can be used here as well. Excellent. So I don't have to set up any JavaScript or anything like that. Instead, I can go directly to my backend implementation and implement it. So I asked for a method that can increase a counter. So let's first add the counter as an integer to my event handler class, and a method called increase. This was going to be my action behind the button, right? I'll add it with one parameter, which is the integer for how much we would increase it. And I'm going to make this method return DOM changes, which is a class from Medusa. I'm doing this because I want the results of this action to be a change in the DOM. And the change that I want is that the counter value gets updated, like this. And then I also want to set up initial values. I want an initial value for the counter, which it will use when it first renders the page. So by adding a setup attributes method, I can specify my initial data, which is the value of counter. And that's it. No glue required. The framework handles everything from here. So let's run this. And you can see my button updates the field properly. That was easy. Check out the documentation for all other things that you can do, like iterations and conditionals. But every time, the goal is to keep the HTML very simple. Any complex logic should really be in the Java code. Okay, so let's now showcase the bidirectionality of this as well. I want to start something from the server side and have that update the UI. So let's say we add a second counter, which we can't update through a button press, but the server will update it on a schedule. So let's first go to our HTML and add the second counter. And then in our event handler, let's add the second counter integer first and add it as an initial value so that on the first render, it has at least some data. And then next, I'm going to add a scheduled method. This has nothing to do with Medusa. This is pure Spring. I'm going to let this be called every 2 seconds. And I'm going to make sure that in my application, I enable scheduled. And then, as you might know, this will run in a separate thread from the user calling anything. So this is not related to user activity. This is purely from the server on that it decides to send information. And in this case, I'm going to send out my updates to everyone connected. If I wanted to specify a specific user, that's easy. I can just do send to session instead of send to all and point it to a session ID. The session ID I could get from my active session registry, which contains all of the session IDs that are currently active, and it's linked to WebSocket sessions or security contexts. So I can make associations fairly quickly, and I can make them in either an initial render, which has security context, or upon an action, which has WebSocket sessions. So in order to get a WebSocket session, I could just add a parameter in one of my actions, and it will automatically be filled in a very Spring-like way and give you the specific session ID for that person. This kind of functionality will likely get further refactors later down the line just to make all of this easier to grab. And right now, for the example, I'm just going to send it to everyone who's active. So I'm just going to use send all. And that's it. So we're sending DOM changes to all people on the schedule. So if we reload a page now, we can see that the server does increase its own counter, and we can also do increases of our own counter. That's Medusa in a nutshell. Again, feel free to check out the documentation for more functionality. This project is still actively under development, so expect to see some changes to it, especially in regards to Hydra functionality. Thanks. Bye.